Welcome to your penultimate update of this Singer Schools Rugby League here on the papare.com, sharing the passion of this school's rugby season with you. And it was probably the closest weekend of schools rugby that we've seen so far, Sabir. It has been an outstanding weekend, some superb games, some outstanding results, and some even better play in the middle over the 80 minutes. Let's start with the St. Peter's versus St. Thomas's game. I was very happy to be at that game. I was torn between going to Royal St. Joseph's and then commentating the St. Peter's St. Thomas's. I'm glad I chose the game that I did, because it was a thumping 25 points to 17 win in the end by St. Thomas's, who were trailing by 17 points to 10 at one time, 10 points to 8 at halftime as well. Nishan Pereira for the Pete Rice, putting them into a lead, and they thought it was going to be plain sailing from there, but St. Thomas's really showing that grit that had been missing from their game for the last maybe 5 or 6 games, Sabir, and they came through and won that 25 points to 17. Almost a completely different side. And I don't mean personnel, but the way they played, it was almost a completely different side that turned up in the blue and black jersey. A few personnel changes, Carter coming in for Pandula De Silva, the senior man at hooker, and making a real difference in the line-out. His throws to number six was something that really helped the possession stakes and also helped St. Thomas's move that driving maul from which they scored a couple of tries. Hasid Senanayake, also the captain, having probably the game of his life, his best game in the Thomian captain's armband for sure. And Sachit Jayatilaka with 2 tries also standing out there. And Jayawardhana at fullback, playing his first game for St. Thomas's, and that was a real outstanding performance from him at fullback as well. And I thought Ishak Jurangpati didn't do much in offense, Sabir, but he did excellently in curtailing Nishan Pereira when he and Nishan were matched up in that number 13 position. And Nishan moved to fullback a little while into the second half, because Diat Fernando suffered quite a serious injury. Hope he's going to be okay. And coach Ben McDougall opted not to put Dixon on in a like-for-like replacement. Instead, he put on Avishka Heenpalda to the number 13 position, moved Nishan Pereira to fullback, and Nishan eventually ended up scoring 2 tries from that position. But then when Kevin Dixon came off, it was Heenpalda that came off this time as well. And although Dixon did make one fabulous run, it was not enough, because St. Thomas has just managed to hold on by the skin of their teeth without letting him under the post. So it was really a really gutty performance from St. Thomas's. St. Peter's will be disappointed by the way that they played, because they expected to come out with a big win after their performance against Royal. But somehow St. Thomas's just didn't allow them to play. It was really a good win, and the Archibald Pereira Trophy coming to Mount Lavinia after quite a long time. Then you were at the St. Joseph's versus Royal College game, Sabir.
Yes, Shanaka, that was absolutely physical battle, I would say. Something like South Africa playing Wallabies or South Africa playing Argentina. The forwards game was tremendous, because at the last 5 minutes we witnessed that how physical tests came to a quest, because some of the passes, they don't know, they didn't have support, especially for Royal. They didn't have support to put the pass. They didn't have strength to pass, in fact. That much a physical battle. And also, I didn't expect St. Joseph's putting such a magnificent performance, but it was really in vain after all, because 20th minute, Chanaka, St. Peter's, St. Joseph's leading 20 points to 3. And from the second quarter onwards, Royal took totally game under their control. It was, their forwards play coming, but so much loose forward. Gayal Jaisingh had so much space out wide. Tariq Sadi was isolated with his fly half calling for support. But if Gayal Jaisingh had sent the ball to the line work, they could have scored more. But overall, Shanaka, it was a brilliant game. It was worth the money watching as a physical game. So it will be interesting how the final is going to be against for the Royals against Isipathana.
And I think for St. Joseph's, Sabir, it was a bit of a slap in the face, because everyone was talking about Royal Isipathana from 2 weeks ago. And St. Joseph's were like, hey, we are playing Royal in between. Why is nobody talking about this game? And I think they wanted to prove a point, and they proved that point coming out. But unfortunately for them, that 17 points to 3 lead, they should have kicked to the corners, held on to that lead, ground them down. But that Stefan Gregory yellow card really proving to be the turning point in that game, because Royal scored from a couple of mauls since then. They didn't have the muscle to hold the Royal Maul when Gregory was out. And this is deja vu for Royal, because I don't know if you remember when Johan Kaiser was the big prop forward playing for St. Joseph's. He got yellow carded in a game and they ended up losing that one as well. So St. Joseph's have a history of relying on their big props as ball carriers, and unfortunately they have a history of yellow cards to those guys as well. But Royal, a good gutty performance from them as well, coming through in the last moment. And I think that defensive showing towards the end of that game, Sabir, will give them some confidence going into a real good attacking team like Isipathana.
And also, Shanaka, the way St. Joseph's performed last week, we never thought that they will put so much performance on this week, last weekend. The thing is, they really analyzed the Royal strength. We all know what Royal strength is. And they took the challenge, even from the forwards play. Even they scored when Stefan Gregory was out on yellow card. So they went to counter their driving maul. They went to counter their physical hits and close hits. So they were coming with a clear plan. So they took the challenge, but it was just fell short. So not only that, Shanak, I was so impressed about Tariq Salih's leadership, because referee was giving a warning, prior warning for Tariq Salih. Maybe he's talking too much, but he showed his leadership skills. He was going to the referee and asking why is that, why that whistle was, why that foul play was. He was trying to slow down the game. Not only that, he's going for the reason to ask the referee, and he's giving back to the players. So in one incident, even the crowd goes shouting, come on, referee, show your colors, send him out, send him out. But he was isolated with the referee. Referee having took the card and he was just marking him. But the other vice captain, Shamil Kakurumbala Pitia, came into him and referee, is that okay? Please keep him on the ground, because they know the value of keeping Tariq Salih on the field. So luckily, referee didn't show any cards. So it was again 15 against 15. So that game went really nicely. But just to admit the fact that Shaukat Lahir played a monumental game, Shanaka. He against Salih, the tackles are bone-crunching tackles. It was really great to watch. I would like to watch the replay, but unfortunately, we don't have a replay to watch. So moving on to the next game, Shanaka, Trinity College 22 against Isipathana College 37. Once again, they are taking the unbeaten run.
Yeah, and it was not as easy as it looks on the scoreboard, Sabir, because Trinity were leading for quite a few moments in that game. It was 15 points to 13 at one stage. They threw everything at Isipathana in the first half. But towards the end, I think the conditioning is something that came into play, because I don't think Trinity are as well conditioned as they should be. They're certainly not in the same sort of condition as maybe even Science College, St. Joseph's, Isipathana and even Royal. I think those teams are a little bit ahead of the other teams when it comes to conditioning, and that's what came to play in the last few moments of that game, because Chamot Fernando intercepting and scoring a late try to put some icing on this scoreboard of 37 points to 22, 37 points to 22, and that's exactly what Trinity didn't want. They didn't want to let Isipathana get away from them, but after being tryless in two games, Omalka Gunaratna once again leading the charge and leading the fight back for Isipathana. So good to see him in form.
Absolutely. Two assists and one try. And also Trinity, Isipathana missing five conversion. Once again, the kicking boots coming back when it is going to be a crucial decide the next week. So that is a concern. But also Dilan Garlic and Puncheva, their main ace who can score more tries, they could not score on this match. And they didn't get much ball, Shanaka. I mean, last week we saw, the week before we saw, they're running few yards with the ball, but not against Trinity. They were well planned, but unfortunately, they could not make yards with the ball.
What I'd like to see, and what we saw against Sion Sabir, was Puncheheva coming in off his wing, looking for that inside pass from Kongahawata. Galage coming in off his wing and running that 12-13 channel as well. And that's what I think they've got to do against Royal, because I think what St. Joseph showed as well with their winger scoring two tries through the midfield is something that will need a little bit of work for Royal. Their midfield defense between Iddavala and Gamage needs to improve. So that's something that I think Nilfa Ibrahim will be targeting next week.
Absolutely. Moving on to the next match at Mount Lanier, Science College beat Kingswood College 37 points to 22. In the halftime, it was only 23 points against 22. Just like Royal St. Joseph, Science led the first quarter 20 points to 3, and Kingswood came back with 3 back-to-back tries. And we were talking about inside channel, the wingers running inside channel, Shanaka, but Reza Rafaidin, he took he made two tries from inside channel from Faris Ali, and he sprinted. No one is to mark Reza Rafai. So Kingswood really put some tremendous pressure before the first half, but they could not capitalize that into the second half. Science took fully control out of that game, Shanaka.
One of my biggest regrets this season, Sabir, is that I haven't seen this boy play yet. We've talked so much about him, Rafaidin, but it seems he's kicking points, he's scoring tries. He seems to be one of the complete players. And the last time I remember a Kingswood fly half us talking about so much in a school's team was Fazil Marija. And he, of course, was part of a fantastic side. He had Gayan Veeraratna, Thirina Manoj, Heshan Premaratna, all those guys who were outstanding players. But Rafaidin seems to be fighting a lone battle. And it would be nice to see him in a good side, in a team that can complement his skills as well. So that's something that I'm really looking forward to seeing when we play that Colombo versus Kandy match eventually at the end of this season. But Science College has been a team that has flattered to deceive. They've had some good players, but just haven't been able to combine enough to make the top guns be a bit scared. And I think that the win against St. Joseph's is probably the biggest win of their season so far. But as expected, I think Science College beating Kingswood. I didn't expect Kingswood to come through and win this one.
So that's all four matches summary that we had. So moving on next for the top try scorer, point scorer list, Shanaka, Supun once again leads the list with 14 tries, Omalka Gunaratna with 12 tries, and Saranga Gunatilaka and Reza Rafaidin 10 tries each. In fact, Reza Rafaidin scoring 17 points once again out of 22 against Science. So Stefan Gregory and Nishon Pereira 9 tries each. And in the points list, Saranga Gunatilaka have scored 100 points so far, and he played only 7 games. Reza Rafaidin chasing Saranga, his candy opposition, with 96 points. And Shamilka Kurumbalapitiya 81 points, Supun Varnakurusuriya 70 points with all his tries. Tanuja Maduranga, Science Center, has scored 63 points, and Omalka Gunaratna with all his tries, 60 points. Moving on to the next week, final clash, Shanaka predictions.
Well, we've got St. Joseph's versus Trinity, which should be a really physical game again as well. And I think that St. Joseph's might just have the edge in this one unless they've left too much on the park after this effort against Royal. But Isipathana also took Trinity right down to the wire. So both teams will be quite tired. So it'll be interesting to see how well they recover before next week's clash. And given the form that both teams have been in, I would probably pick St. Joseph's for that one. St. Peter's versus Science is going to be a really interesting game, Sabir. And after last week's loss, St. Peter's will want to come back and try and win that game, and they will have a point to prove. But Science College, I think, are a little bit more, I think they're a little shrewder as a team. I think Lasindo Ishan is an outstanding leader for that Science College team. They've got guys, if Tharid Maduranga is fit again, I think he's a guy that can change things around in midfield. So they've got a dangerous running team, and St. Peter's defense didn't look all that flash against St. Peter. So unless they've tightened up that defense across the midfield, things are going to look a bit hairy for them, but that's another very close game. St. Thomas's versus Kingswood, if they play like they did against St. Peter's, they will beat Kingswood. If the St. Thomas's College side that started off the season turns up next week, then they will lose against Kingswood. It's as simple as that. So at the moment, St. Thomas's is playing a little bit like Pakistan, but if they play to their potential as they showed against St. Peter's, I think it should be a comfortable victory with the set of forwards that they have. And then it comes to the big one, Sabir, Royal College versus Isipathana. Unfortunately, we won't be able to bring you that game live on the papre.com. We'll certainly be there watching it though, and it should be just an outstanding encounter. It's too close to call, because I think both sets of forwards are as good as the other. And I think where Royal have a little bit of an advantage is their third row as a unit, Sabir, led by Supun Vannakulasuriya. They have Shaukat Lahir, as you mentioned earlier on, and Keshan Piris. And I think those guys add a lot of flair to this Royal team, because Lahir is the defender, he's the guy that makes the tackles, he's the guy that's roving all over the park. Piris is the ball carrier. Vannakulasuriya does what he's expected to as a number 8. He's throwing into the line out as well, and he controls that mall. So as a unit, I think he's there. That aspect of Royal's game is a little better than Isipathana's. Omalka Gunaratna, maybe as a like-for-like comparison against Again, Supermanakula Surya, maybe he's a better ball carrier. But in terms of having the same combination with Veerasekara and Kolumbige, who most often plays on the flank, then I think as a unit, the third row of Royal is a little bit better. But where Royal will be exposed is the back three. I think that's what St. Joseph's tried to do against him as well. They tried but failed. And I think Isipathana, if Kongahawatta has a good game, that's where things are going to get good for them. But in the halves combination as well, I think Ashok and Gael Jayasinghe have been the standout combination this season, and between Bandara and Kongahawatta, I don't think they have been as good. But if Kongahawatta gets a bit of space to kick, I think we're in for a good battle, because Kushan Indunil and Chamoth Fernando in the midfield are probably a shade better than Iddavala and Banduka Gamage at this present moment. But you know, it's going to be really difficult to call.
And also, if you watch the, we all know the Royal strength is their driving ball, number one. If you watch the under 20 championship last evening between France against New Zealand, France in fact scored the first try with their driving ball. New Zealand could not stop their pack forward, they had so much weight on it. And from the next line out onwards until the 80th minute, France did not New Zealand did not contest a single line out. So something like that against Royal, which Peters did against St. Joseph's did, and we expect Isipathana to also do that probably. It might happen. So if you are thinking that is illegal or that is not sportsmanship, well, Baby Blacks did, so that's all tactical play. So that's all we have from the week 8 penultimate week roundup. And finally, just to mention you about the Gillette Mark III free shave, you can get a free shave at Royal Complex Ground in the grand finale between Royal College and Isipathana College, because 10th shave of Gillette Mark III is still more comfortable than the first of a disposable. Shanaka, you know why I didn't have my shave yet? Because I'm going to for a free shave and after the finals.
I might take a shave before that with a Gillette Mark III, because I might need to go in disguise to the Royal College Sports Complex. But I hope the only close shave I have is in the loo with my Gillette Mark III. But looking forward to a fantastic end to the season in Sigar Schools Rugby. We will be sharing the passion with you on www.thepapare.com.
This probably isn't your first shave. You already have your first razor. You know how to shave. So we won't waste your time telling you to wash with warm water before putting on a generous layer of shave gel. Instead, we'll show you how to do other things, like how to appreciate art. And since this isn't your first shave, we wouldn't dream of telling you that our razors are designed to go with and against the grain. You already know that. So we'll show you how to negotiate. And since this isn't your first shave, we'd never in a million years have to tell you to rinse with cold water to refresh your face. Not a chance. Instead, we'll show you how to accept an award. And we're definitely not going to end this video with a girl admiring our guy's smooth shave. No way. But we will show you this beautiful woman just for the heck of it. This isn't your first how to shave video or your first razor, but they're both likely your first real ones.